His time of death arrived. At that time, he began to think of his son without any other thought.
Sarivam Bhaktamana Abhya Mrittu Kale Upasthite Matim Chakaru Kamai Bhadi Narayana Ava. Bhaktamana, everyone is situated under certain condition. This is material life. I am situated under certain consciousness. You are situated in certain consciousness. Everyone, according to the modes of nature, there are different conceptions of life and different consciousness. That is called material. All of us who are sitting here, every one of us has got a different consciousness. Generally, it is meant for sentient. Material like me, everyone is planned. I shall live like this, I shall have our money like this, I shall enjoy like this. Everyone has got a program. So, Ajamila also had a program. What is his program? His program was, as he is very much attached to his youngest child, and whole attention is there, how the child is moving, how the child is eating, how the child is talking, and sometimes he was calling, he was feeding. His whole mind was absorbed with the activities of the child. In the previous class we have already discussed. Punyanam prabhuvam khadam balakam suhajam sudha bhujayam payan mura na vidha adatam samtatam. Not only Ajahn and Emriya, there have gone Sajan Taylor, consciousness. And what is due to it, how the consciousness works, you say Smeha Dhamma. Smeha means affection. By the affected by the machine, which is called affection. Everyone is affected by this machine. This machine, the body is machine, and it is being worked by the nature. And direction is coming from the Supreme Law. We wanted to enjoy a certain way, and Krishna has given us a certain type of body, jantra. Just like we have got defined, make some more of that. You want, somebody wants, I want big car, somebody says, hey, similar way, four. They're ready. Similarly, our body is also like that. Somebody is four, somebody is three or less, somebody is weak. And Krishna has given us the chance. He wanted this kind of car or body. You sit down and enjoy. This is our material. Ishara sarva bhutanam nitteshe arjuna tishtati. We forget after changing the body, we forget what I desire and why I am not this kind of body. But Krishna is situated within your heart, he does not forget. He gives you. This is how our promoter. He wanted this kind of body. You get it? Krishna is so bad. And somebody wanted a body so that he can eat everything. So Krishna gives him the body of a pig so that he can eat in stool. And if somebody wanted a body that I shall dance with Krishna, then he gets that body. That is up to you to decide whether you are going to get a body which will be able to dance with Krishna, to talk with Krishna, to play with Krishna, you can get it. And if you want a body, how to eat stool, urine, you get it. So we have to decide. This human form of life. But if you have no information that what kind of body you are going to get next, if you don't believe, you believe or not believe, then the nature's law will act. If you say, I don't believe in the next life, you may say like that, but nature's law will act. Karmanādhiyunatrena, as you are acting, according to that, you are preparing your next one. So after that phase, when this body is finished, then you get another body. Immediate. Because you have already made the field one. What kind of body is there? So, this man, Ajami, was engaged in taking care of his child. Very nice thing, that the old mind was absorbed in the child. So,
the magisters.
Therefore, he has been described as Mula. As you say, Bhojan Parayana Mula. We are forgetting that someday is coming, that is ahead, that is called Mrityu. Death. We want it. But this is our imperfect. So this man forgot that he was very busy as an affectionate father, or affectionate husband. But in the wife of so many relationships, as an affectionate friend, or envious enemy, we have got some relationships. And with everyone in this world, we have got some. Either it may be affectionate or envy, it doesn't matter. So, in this way we are living, forgetting that death is ahead. Therefore, we are moving. Buddha means trusted, ass, who does not know what is actual interest. Well, ass, Buddha means ass. The ass does not know his own interest. We have seen the ass is loaded with 3 tons of flour by the devotional man. And he cannot go a stage of bread, and he does not know that I am loading so many tons of flour on my back, and what interest I got with. Not a single flour belongs to me. So the ass has nothing. Ass means he has no substance. He is thinking it is my duty to load upon me so much burden. It is my duty. Why it is duty? And because the washerman gives you grass. So he has no sense that grass I can get anywhere. Why I have taken this duty? So this is the everyone's answers about his duty, somebody's politician, somebody's householder, somebody's something else. But because he has taken up some false duty and working hard for it, therefore he is an ass. He is forgetting his real duties. Real business is that death will come. It will not have happened. Everyone says, as sure as death. But before death, I have to act in such a way that I may have a position in Vaikuntha and Vrindavan, and I may have permanent right to be with Krishna. This is our real duty. But we do not know. Rate Vibhu Sadhugatin Vishnu. We are in this conditioned state of life because we are separated from our original person, Krishna. Because we are part and parcel of Krishna. We are forgotten. We are thinking we are part and parcel of America. All in. This is called illusion. They are interested, somebody is interested in his country, somebody is interested in his society or family. We have created so many things. Therefore, Shastra said that these rascals do not know what is his actual self-interest. He is hoping something which he will never improve. That's what he does. We are trying to adjust things within this material world to become happy. But the rascal does not know that so long he will remain in this material world, there is no question of happiness. That is rascal. Krishna says, that this place is Dukkhalam Asasadam. This material world where we are now living, under the change of body one after another, it is Dukkhalam. Why I have to change my body? Why not? I am permanent. Then we have to learn, we have to be educated, we have to receive knowledge from the perfect. And Krishna personally, but the supreme perfect person is giving you. If you are so unfortunate that you do not get the perfect knowledge, you will come back, you will speculate, you create our own idea. That it is to be understood that do not we are thinking I shall be happy in this way, I shall be happy in this way. Nothing. It shall never be happy. This is perfect wisdom. Unless you go back to home. It's like a mad boy, yes, forsaken his father. His father is rich man, everything is there, but he has become guilty. So, similarly, we are also like that. Our father is Krishna. We can be there very comfortably, without any bothersome, without endeavor for earning money. But we have decided that we shall be here in this mission. This is God. That of Mula. We do not know what is ourself. And we are hoping against, I shall be happy in this way, I shall be happy in this way. Therefore, this word is used, Mula. They do not know what is actually his happiness and his trying. One chapter another, now I will be happy to react. Yes, sometimes the waterman sits on his back and takes a bunch of grass and puts in front of the ass, and the ass wants to take the grass. But as you're moving forward, the grass is also moving forward. And he thinks just one step forward, I shall get the grass. But because his ass, he does not know that the grass is situated in such a way that I can go on for millions of years, still I am not getting it. This is it. He does not come to his senses that for millions and trillions of years I may try to be happy in this particular world, I will never be happy. Therefore, you have to take the knowledge from the Guru to know things that the Guru is watching. Avgyana priyam dasya gyanamjana salataya. Chakshu unmititam jena tasmai sigra. The politician or leaders, Anda, they will promise you that he will be happy in this way, you give me vote, and I shall make him for you, and let him become minister, that is what he should be with. And as soon as I become minister and president, I will give you such and such. So you select Mr. Nixon, and again you become disappointed. Then we request Mr. Nixon to get out. And we accept another two. But Shastra said, you will not be getting right information in that way. This foolish man, they will promise you something and is unable to make you happy. You will be again disappointed, very regret. Then what is but now I shall get the right information. Then Leela said, Pabhijyanatham Chagurumeva Abhivacche. If you want right information, then go to the Guru. And the Guru, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained, that Amar and thy Guru Hariya Tarasara. He said, you just become on my order. Guru means who carries the order of Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna. Or is Krishna servant, there is Guru. Nobody can become Guru unless he carries the order of the Supreme. Therefore, he finds, because every one of us asks, we do not know what is our self-interest, and somebody comes, I am Guru. How we become Guru? No, I am self-perfected. I don't require to need any Guru. I have come to bless you. The police ask them, they do not know how you can become Guru. If he does not follow this Shastra or the Supreme authority, Krishna, how he can become? But they accept. So this kind of Guru is going. But you should know, Guru means who carries the order of the Supreme Lord. Any rascal who manufactures some idea is not Guru. Immediately kill him up. Immediately. That he, this is a rascal, this is not a Guru. Guru is here at Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Amar Adnai Guru. Guru means the faithful servant of God. Very good. So you have to first of all say, are you faithful servant of God? If he says no, I am God. Kill him on his face immediately. You have come to teach us. Because taste is there, that Guru means faithful servant of God. Simple. Don't require large definition of it. So basic knowledge gives you indication that Tabhigyana, if you want to know the science of spiritual life, Tabhigyana. So Guru Bhaiva Vidache, you must have Guru. And the Guru means who is the faithful servant. So, this is the question. Without Guru, if he is manufacturing his way of life, then he is Mura. That's what he said. Mura. You are thinking, I am so affectionate father, I am taking care of my son, little son. In all respect, I am feeding him, I am petting him, so many things happen. I am very faithful, I am very modest father. But Shastra said, here is a mura, rest. You see, he said, bhojan, panan, mura. Why is mura? Na veda, padatam, antakam. He does not say, does not know that behind me the death is everything. Yes, completely. Now, how your affection for your so-called son and society and family and nation will save you? Here is death. Very good. You can cannot answer the death. So we shall be prepared. That is human life. We must always know that there is death behind you. At any moment you can capture my death and hit. That's a plan. Is there any guarantee that you shall live 100 years? No. Even just after you second, if you go to this state, you may immediately be dead. There will be heart failure, there will be a motor accident, there will be something. So, to live is wonderful. To die is not wonderful. Because you are meant for death. As soon as you took your birth, immediately you begin to die. Immediately. This is very bad. Oh, when the child is born, you say in one way. That means he has died one way. We are taking that he is living one way, but actually he has died one way. That is wonderful. That is still he is living, he has not died. So, death is not wonderful, because it is sure, it will come after one week or after 100 years. That is not wonderful. So long you live, that is wonderful. So we should utilize this time to make solution of the life that we are repeatedly dying and again accepting another body. So how they will understand unless they come to the proper group? Therefore, Shastra said, Prabhujyanartham, if you want to know the real problem of your life, and if you want to be enlightened, how to become Krishna conscious, how to become jnana, go back to home, back to Godhead, then you must approach the Guru. Guru is Guru, and this is the best thing. Guru never manufactures ideas. That you do this and give me money and you become that. That is another process of earning money. So, yes, it is said, Mula, everyone who is simply living in the fool's paradise, manufacturing his own ideas, like for Jari. Somebody has taken, this is my duty, somebody has taken. He is a fool. You must know what is your duty from Guru. You are singing every day, Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chittete Kariya Akka Arana Kariya. This is that. This is that. Guru Mukha Padma, he will accept the bona fide Guru and what he orders you carry out. Then your life is accepted. Arana Kariya. You will ask them if you do not desire anything. But are you not saying them? But do you understand the meaning? How we are saying? What is the meaning? Who is explaining? Nobody knows? Yes, what do you
mean? My only wish is that my mind be purified by the words and the mouth of my spiritual master. I have no other desire for anything else.
Yes, this is God. Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chittete Kariya. Now she comes in consciousness, I shall do this. But my Guru Maharaj told me, I shall. Chittete Kariya Yatra Arna Kariya. So, it is not my pride, but I can say for your instruction, I did. Therefore, whatever little success you see, that my all my God brother will give you. I am not the best. But I took it, the words of my Guru, as life and soul. So this is fact. Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chittete Kariya. Everyone should do that. But if he makes addition or tradition, there is. Yes. No addition. We have to approach Guru. Guru means the faithful servant of God, Krishna, and take his word how to serve him. Then you are successful. If you conquer, I am very intelligent than my Guru. And I can make additional and you have got the opportunity of chanting the holy name. This is his good fortune. Therefore, according to this, we change the name. Why? Because every name is meant for becoming a servant of Krishna. So, just by Upendra. Upendra means Bhavan. So, Yugarupendra, similarly, that name is taken account of. So that will be explained later on. So here also it is said, in the first verse it is said Mura, and the second verse also it is said Saivam Vartamana of Abhava means Saskar. Mura means Saskar, Abhava means ignorant. Ignorant, who has no knowledge. Va means one who has knowledge. Abhya, man who has no knowledge. Mrityu so everyone in this material world, is Mura, Abhya, he does not care that I will have to meet death when everything will be finished, all my plans, all my assets, everything. He does not know. He knows, but he doesn't care to observe these things. Therefore, everyone is Mura and Abhya, and then in spite of the death has come, Matin Chakara Pranayini Bali Narayanao. He is experiencing now I am dying, death is near, still, and he is thinking of his that child. So, Jagadam Bhakti Smaran Loke, Pradatmanta, he has got a child, his name is Narayan. Now his position is defined, but if I am similarly affected, similarly affectionate to my dog, then what is my position? Or anything. Naturally I think of my dog, and immediately I shall get the other body, like a dog or dog. This is nature's law. Janajana Bhavi Smaran Luki Sajatam Dhikariva. At the time, the test will be at the time of death, what kind of body you are going to get. So, Jagadamba Bhavi Smaran Bhava, they, just like he is very much affectionate to his son, he is thinking of his son. Similarly, if you very much affectionate your dog or something else, you think at that time. Therefore, practice Hare Krishna, so that at the time of death you can think of Krishna and your life is successful. Thank you. Yeah.